Vanakkam, this is Haider Ali Sayyed from Asivagam, united under Tamil Shiva.
As per Quran chapter 42 verse 13, everyone followed the same way of life which Prophet Noah has followed, and Noah is from the bloodline of Set, and Set is Shiva, and everyone followed the first Siddha way of life, that is Asivagam. And Asivagam means God guided path. So wherever, when you read Quran, Allah clearly says, Allah guides whom He wills. And how the guidance comes is through conscious of God. So when you are into meditative state and spiritualism and you get connected with God, that's what the ancient traditions were all following, whether it be India, Africa, South America, America, China. Because we, from 2500 years, we have been enslaved by the Caucasians, outsiders, who are enslaving us with their anti-spiritual policy. They are not ruling us with arms and ammunition, but they are ruling us with anti-spiritual policy. And today we have become a religious country. India has become a religious country. Africa has become a religious country. And we are fighting among each other, and we have lost our superpower status. The story of the earth, the trading post, everything was controlled by India and the African children of Israel. So this thing has been, we have lost everything. And since China is still maintaining their tradition way of life, they are following the tradition way of life, and today God has given them the status of superpower, whether it be China, whether it be Japan. So we have to look in a different angle. If you want to come up in life without killing your own brothers in the name of religion, we have to see where we went wrong. And Quran is there to correct us. So if we can ponder on Quranic verses, I think we can bring peace on the earth. By converting and calling ourselves Muslim, we see Shia is fighting with Sunni, Sunni is fighting with Wahhabi, everything the whole Muslimdom is fighting with each other. So we cannot connect those people with Quran, because Quran is separate and those people are separate. You're getting the point? So we have to understand Quran, because Quran is a time travel book from Adam, before Adam also, and Noah, family of Abraham and family of Imran. So these are the history book for those certain people. So outsiders cannot write based on religion, they cannot rewrite our history. Hope I made my point clear.
Go ahead, so.
No, it's fine, thank you.
Just gonna say, you said China adopted their own spiritual religion. So I know they follow Buddhism. So are you talking along those lines, like Buddhism? Or just talking about
Buddhism again? We are talking about religion, because when Gautam Buddha.
No, but like Buddhism, they meditate, find enlightenment.
I'll come to that point. I'll come to that point, because see, the purpose of Prophet Gautam Buddha, as per the Quranic name, his name is Zulkif. Okay. And the purpose of he's actually a prince.
Yeah.
And when he saw his certain thing in his kingdom, he left the palace and he went into the jungle to meditate. And he activated his Kundalini and he came back again. And he stood against the anti-spiritual policy of the Caucasian Brahmins. Because that time the Brahmins were telling that through priestly cult you have to attain moksha or salvation. You're getting the point. So, and when Gautam Buddha came, he said, no human can give moksha or salvation. Do meditation and get connected with higher conscience. And then he talked about then that there was Brahminism who wrote lots of pornography in our tradition way of life. Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. If you read it, you'll find full of pornography. So Gautam Buddha said, now you don't have to do zikr of meditation. That is called Anapana Vipassana, where we don't have to chant any God's name, because the God which we were pronouncing in our language has been corrupted. It was full of pornography. So that was the purpose of Gautam Buddha. And then later on, Kalingar war happened, and there's a trend. Whenever the Prophet used to come, after certain times, the war used to take place. And then under the name of Buddha, they started a religion called Buddhism. Happened in every age. Like for example, Jesus came for Lordship of House of Israel, not for Gentiles. But the Roman Gentiles, they started a religion called Roman Catholic, which was started from by the Roman Empire. Similarly, same thing happened with Prophet Muhammad. Prophet Muhammad never entertained the Caucasian settlers, Roman Empire, Persian Empire. And after 200 years, these people, they started writing Hadith, and they started a religion called Shia, Sufi, Sunni, Wahhabi, which came later on. So this is what is it's happening in every age. Line of Prophet Muhammad, Quran is completed, Deen is is under the protection of Allah. So there is no need for us to go after books which is written after 200 years. You're getting the point. And that too, as per Quran, yep. As per the Quran, Roman Empire, Persian Empire, Prophet Muhammad never entertained. So, since Prophet Muhammad followed the same way of life which Prophet Noah has followed, and Noah followed the first Siddha way of life, that is called Asivagam, and Asivagam means God-guided path, and through meditation, through yoga, one can activate his Kundalini chakra and get connected with higher conscious. This is what all the tradition way of life used to follow. And then we have this ancient tradition of remembering our ancestors, that is called Kuldevam. And Mecca is a Kuldevam for family of Ibrahim, where the ancestors get together place for family of Ibrahim. So this is actually the thing. So everything is connected. But since the Caucasians, the barbaric people, wherever they went, they started a religion, and through religion they used to make money. And after in 1926, when South entered into Hijaz region, genociding 8 lakh black people and conquering Mecca, Medina, they started, again they promoted this Hajj concept, and today it is globally everyone is converting and going to Hajj, and who's benefiting? Saudi Arabia is benefiting. So the question is, even if you read when chapter 9 verse 28 clearly says they are not allowed to enter into Hijaz region, so why they are going against that? So when you identify by and as I have shown you in Quran that chapter 7 verse 172 and chapter 23 verse 199, we are all connected with our ancestors. So when we meditate, we will remember our what testimony we had with God. Remember, so everything is inside. So meditation is very important. And
I just want to say, so the house of Allah, the Mecca, was just for the children Israel.
Yes, it's one of the trading posts, and it was only meant for the family of Abraham.
So why did Allah bring the stone from heaven? Like,
which stone?
What was the purpose? He wanted them to worship them at Mecca, just the children Israel.
No. No one worships stones. That stone is all, what do you say? The stone is not mentioned in Quran. Where in the Quran it is mentioned that a stone came about?
It's not mentioned from heaven. It's mentioned in the Hadith.
See, the Hadith, that stone was robbed, was installed.
There are many Hadiths fake, Mandal.
Okay.
There are many Hadiths fake.
Okay. So, Taylor, the thing is, whatever the Quran is, the deen got completed through Prophet Muhammad, and the Quran is the ultimate book. And after whatever is written after Prophet Muhammad, because that cannot be considered as religion. Because when Quran is completed, we have to see whether that thing is mentioned in Quran. So the headline is from Quran, we can check the Hadith for explanation. If headline is not there, we cannot come out with new concept.
So what's the point of Mecca then?
Mecca is actually, what I'm telling you is, Mecca is a safe house. When you read Quran, Ibrahim made a safe house for his family. And when Jerusalem was being attacked by Roman Empire, and the Ark of Covenant went missing. So family of Ibrahim, the children of Israel, they fled from their land and they migrated to Arabia. And they were living among the Prophet Muhammad. And when Prophet Muhammad came, he started preaching about Dina Ibrahim, family of Ibrahim, because that was the turning point. And then he explained the concept of what was the real religion, monotheism. So then later on, after Fateh Makkah, the Roman Empire, Persian Empire, was not allowed to enter into Hijaz region. And
So why does Allah say that Mecca is his house then?
Mecca is a house, yeah. It's a house.
Allah says like that's my house though.
Yes, every house is there, his house. Even the Koil, K-O-I-L, Koil in India, it means house of a king where God's rules and regulation is being explained. So this is actually it's particularly for the family, because family of Ibrahim was trained. Ibrahim was trained. Around 2000 BC, and his family hold the rank of administration because Allah knew he is the best of planner, and he knew about what will happen to his people, so he made a different process to safeguard his people. So that's why.
So the Mecca was just a safe house
for family of Abraham.
Incoming attacks. So yeah, family of Abraham. Don't get killed.
Yeah, family of Abraham, and it take and during the timeline of Prophet Muhammad before his birth, a Roman king Abraha traveled all the way to Mecca to destroy the Kaaba, but no one objected. Yep. No one objected, but he left, and Allah destroyed them. So, like Kaaba, yep. Quran is also protected by Allah. So, and Quran is very clear, Allah guides whom He wills. So, through meditation, yeah. through activation of Kundalini Chakra, we can get connected with Lohe Mehfooz also. Because Quran says, only the pure can touch the Lohe Mehfooz. So, if you have that spiritually thing, you can get connected with higher consciousness. At the same time, you can get access to Lohe Mehfooz also and get the information from there.
So, this whole going to Aj and walking around the Kaaba 7 times is all fake?
It's for a family of Ibrahim, not for... because the ritual is done by Hajra. Okay, the ritual there, Zamzam, Ismail, connected with Ismail. Safa Marwa, again, is connected with, Hajra. It's a ritual. And there is a verse in Quran.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a verse in Quran where Ibrahim is talking to, praying to Allah that, sustain my family which I have left in a... uncultivated land, referring to Hagar yep. family, and how Allah, because agriculture, Allah cannot change the climate to make it a desert into a fertile land. But what he did, he told Abraham to slaughter his son Ismail, and he took Ismail to the place called Mina, and when he did it, a ram came between them. So, and today whoever is going...
Did he give the Zamzam water?
Yeah. No, Zamzam is for when the child was small. I'm talking about Mina, when Ibrahim brought Ismail to sacrifice. So, Mina
okay,
is... Some,
okay, okay.
So, at the place of Mina, so today whoever is going for Hajj, so whenever the family of Ibrahim, whoever is going to their Kuldeva, they are supposed to do sacrifice. And that meat was being utilized by the member of the clan living in Mecca. Similarly, in our Kuldevam, when there was everyone goes and sacrifices a hen, a goat or anything to their Kuldeva. So this is a culture which is done in every tradition. So there's a verse in Quran which says that sacrifice is being ordained to all the tradition way of life. So it's talking about the Kuldevan. When you see,
but does it mention? Yeah. Does it mention in the Quran about Hajj and Umrah? Does it mention that in the Quran? Because I don't remember.
Yeah, it's mentioned in Hajj and Umrah, and there's a verse in Quran. Like suppose you're celebrating Bakri Eid now, right?
Yeah.
But is Bakri Eid? Did Prophet Muhammad celebrated Bakri Eid?
Eid al-Zuha,
which we are doing, is again is a Hindu concept or a Zoroastrianism concept, not an Islamic concept. Because a chapter when the Prophet Muhammad was stopped from going into, he had haram and everything, and he was supposed to go to perform Hajj, but as he was not allowed to enter into Mecca. So Quran verses telling, send your Hadi to the place of sacrifice, and when the animal is sacrificed there, shave your head. This is what the Quranic instruction is. So my question is,
yeah.
When Prophet Muhammad did not sacrifice his animal outside the Hajj, he was in the haram and he sent his place of Hadi. Today in India, in Pakistan, all over the world, people are sacrificing animal in the name of Hajj or in the name of Eid al-Zuha. Is it...
Because when we go to Mecca, we have to do the rituals of certain prophets. So we go around. There'll be a walk up and down because of what Hajar done for her son.
Safa Marwa, up and down. Safa Marwa, I think.
Yeah, Safa Marwa. Yeah.
Yes. So, and that's just to honor the journey and the sacrifice of Hajar for her son Ishmael. Alayhi salam. We also go around the Kaaba 7 times because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did that.
Yeah.
So it's just a ritual of just.
Does that say in the Quran that he went 7 times around?
No, but that's part of the Sunnah. The Sunnah is just what the Prophet did and said.
That's a question.
So there's no mention in the Quran
we can have a discussion later on.
The Muslims follow the Sunnah and the Quran.
Now,
I'm a Muslim myself.
I'm talking
I'm
about
asking.
the Bakri Eid or Eid al-Zuha, which has been celebrated all over the world, and thousands of millions of goats and sheep and cow and buffaloes are being slaughtered in the name of Hajj. But Prophet Muhammad
yes.
never
yes.
sacrificed. As per the Quran, he sent his Hadi, because only the people who are going for Hajj, they are supposed to do sacrifice. And Prophet Muhammad went.
No.
Yeah, Prophet Muhammad went.
No,
let me finish. I'm quoting from the Quran. That's the reason why Muslims should understand Quran first before following the religion in the name of Prophet Muhammad and blaming
Prophet.
Yeah, no,
you're right. Yeah, you're right.
So Prophet Muhammad, when he was supposed to go for Hajj, he went for the Hajj and he was stopped. And Allah is telling, send your Hadi to the place of sacrifice. And when the sacrificial animal has been cut, slaughtered, then cut your hair. This is what the Quranic verse is, the chapter 2 and 112, I think so. So,
I want to add one thing in this one.
Yeah.
For all the audience. In Quran, to sacrifice the animal, whether it may be camel, cow, goat, sheep or anything, there in Mecca, who are going to Hajj there only, not for the people,
yeah.
outers.
Yes, that's what
not
I'm telling
for
you.
The other people.
Yeah, that's
they
what
can sacrifice there in Makkah and Medina. It is not necessary for the other peoples who are living around the world.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it's only for when you're in Hajj.
Someone will you believe this one?
Today, every.
But it's only if you're in Hajj.
Do you agree this one?
I'm sorry, I can't understand. Because I'm having a hard time understanding you, but we sacrifice during the Hajj, and that's and
it is the order of Allah during the Hajj. The Hajj, who is going to Hajj, for those people, it is an order, not for other people.
It's just only for the people in Hajj.
Jazakallah, thank you.
Yeah, now what we are doing in the name of Hadith, we are sacrificing animal today in the name of Bakri Eid or Eid al-Zuha. And that too, we take somebody's name, who will be, and connect that concept to Pul Sirat. And on the bigger animal, we take seven people's name. So that we are making it not we are reciting some other's name on the animal. So sacrificing animal in other's name, it's forbidden, no?
Haider sir.
Yes.
There are some poor people also. They are written in books. They are in Maulana in Juma. They are telling in Khutbah that every person should do this. If 6 persons are there in the house, so 6 sheep, 6 goat.
Bharti,
this is zulm, you know, zulm ko kya bolna angrezi mein?
Bharti, I agree with you, but the thing is, if they are so much concerned about the poor people, instead of paying 15,000-20,000 for goat and sheep, they shouldn't get
many
that.
Many people,
so there, it's actually an Islamic culture. Bakri Eid is actually
an Islamic culture.
Satyugam prolonging due to four beastly regime disguised as Muslim world. Satyugam possible only through straight part of first Siddha Tamil Shiva. Nandri Vanakkam.